Good morning. I welcome you all in this lecture. Today I am going to discuss the series solution. You know that there are many differential equations which arise from the physical problem and cannot be solved in terms of a finite linear combination of elementary function. In such a case, we can have the solution in terms of infinite convergence rate. Now, there are many classical differential equations whose solution had many application in terms of in science and engineering, such as Bessel function, your Legendre function, your hypergeometric function, Lagrange function. First, we will start with definition. Consider suppose that this is your a second order differential equation. Where again p1 is a function of x plus q1 y equal to 0. So this is your homogeneous second order differential equation whose right hand side is 0, and your p0, p1 and p2 are functions of x. Now if p0 is not equal to 0, then we can write this differential equation as p1x upon p0 dy by dx plus p2x upon p0x y equal to 0, or we can write it as d2 by dx2 plus p of x dy by dx plus p of x y equal to 0. So this is your standard second order differential equation where my px is equal to p1x upon p0 and our qx is p2x upon p0x. This is known as a standard second order linear differential equation. Now, if my p0 is not equal to 0, if this p0 is not equal to 0, then we will say that the point, if p0 is not equal to 0 at some point x equal to x0, then we will say that our p and q are analytic. That means they are differentiable at that point. If now let us define ordinary point or regular point. So if p0 is not equal to 0, that is your px and qx are differentiable, are analytic. Analytic means they are differentiable at that point. If p0 is not equal to 0, that is px and qx are analytic, that is differentiable at x equal to x0, then we say that x equal to x0 is ordinary point or our regular point. So in this case, if your p and q are analytic at x equal to x0 or differentiable at this point, then we will say that our p and q are analytic and this point is known as your ordinary point. Now suppose that if p and q are not analytic at this point, if px and qx, px or qx, if px or qx or both are not analytic at x equal to x0, that means it can be possible when your p0 is equal to 0, then this x equal to x0 is said to be singular point. So in this case, your x equal to x0 is said to be singular point. Now if this point is singular, then now we will try to make this px and qx at analytic. So if x minus x naught into bx, if x minus x naught into bx and x minus x naught whole square into qx both are analytic at x equal to x naught, then this x equal to x naught is said to be, then this x equal to x naught is said to be regular singular point, otherwise irregular singular point. If these both are analytic at x equal to x naught, then we will say that x equal to x naught is regular singular point. Otherwise, we will say that it is irregular singular point. Irregular singular point means either this or both are not analytic at x equal to x naught. Then this x equal to x naught will be your irregular singular point. So for ordinary point, our P and Q has to be analytic, and for regular singular point, this x minus x naught into P and x minus x naught whole square into Q should be analytic. Okay, now let us find out the series solution at this point, at this x equal to x naught. So, series solution near ordinary point. So if x equal to x naught is the ordinary point of y double dash plus px y dash plus qx y equal to 0, then its series solution is given by y equal to n equal to 0 to infinity an x minus x naught of n, or we can write it as a naught plus a1 x minus x naught plus a2 x minus x naught whole square plus a3 x minus x naught whole cube. Now if this is the ordinary point of this differential equation, then its series solution is given by this. Now, we will differentiate this equation. We will get the first order and second order derivative of this y, and we will put these values here. And then equating the coefficients of various powers of x, we will obtain these coefficients. And after getting the coefficients, we will have the series solution of this differential equation. One minus x square y double dash minus x y dash plus 4y equal to 0. Let us solve this problem near x equal to 0. So solution. Now here, first we will find out the nature of this point, whether this point is your ordinary point or singular point. If this is ordinary, then we will proceed in this way, and if it is singular, then we will have a different method known as Frobenius method. Now in this case, let us write it in standard form. So here we will have our original differential equation is this one. So let us write it in the standard second order differential equation form. So we have this equation. Now clearly your px is minus x upon 1 minus x square. Your qx is 4 upon 1 minus x square. Now here you can see that if you put x equal to 0 here, then both p and q are finite. Or we can say that if you differentiate this p with respect to x, then again in the denominator we will get 1 minus x square whole square, and here we will have 1 minus x square whole square. So we can say that at x equal to 0, both p dash and q dash are finite. That means our p and q are differentiable at x equal to 0. So as p and q are differentiable at x equal to 0, so our x equal to 0 will be ordinary point. So at both p and q are analytic at x equal to 0, so x equal to 0 is ordinary point. So this is your ordinary point. Now let us find out the solution near this ordinary point. Let y equal to n equal to 0 to infinity an x power n is the series solution of 1. Then your y dash will be, we can also write it as a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube and so on. Now your y dash will be one time differentiation will be n into an x power n minus 1. Two time differentiation. Now if you differentiate it one time with respect to x, then you can say that at first time this a naught will be 0 because differentiation of a naught will be 0. So our summation will start from 1. So that is why I am writing here from n equal to 1 to infinity, then the differentiation of x power n will be n into x power n minus 1. Then if you differentiate it again, then the differentiation of a naught will be 0 and again the differentiation of a1 will be 0. So our summation will start from 2. So this is equal to n equal to 2 to infinity n into n minus 1 a x power n minus 2. So let us put the values of y, y dash and y double dash in this equation number 1. Hence 1 implies 1 minus x square y double dash, then we have minus x into y dash, then 4 times an x power n equal to 0. Now let us multiply, let us open this bracket. So if we multiply by 1, we will have n equal to infinity n into n minus 1 an x power n minus 2. Then if we multiply this term by x square, we will have x power n. Then our third term is n equal to 1 to infinity n into an x power n, and fourth term is 4 times this one. So this is equation number 2. Now here, now we have to aim. First we will try to make these powers common. That means we will try to write every term in powers of either x power n or x power n minus 1 or x power n minus 2. So for that we will replace our, for example, this is in powers of x power n, again this is powers in powers of x power n, this is in powers of x power n, but it is in the powers of x power n minus 2. So here we will replace our summation from, we will replace our n from, we will replace our n by n plus 2. So if we replace our summation by n plus 2, then this power will become x power n. This is our first thing. Then we will try to make all the summation common. So after having the common summation, then we can equate the various coefficients of powers of x equal to 0. So we have n equal to 0 to infinity, replace your n by n plus 2, n by n plus 2, then this will be your n plus 2 x power n, then the next term will be minus n equal to 2 to infinity n into n minus 1 an x power n, then the third term will be n equal to 1 to infinity n into an x power n, then the fourth term will be 4 times n equal to 0 to infinity an x power n equal to 0. Okay, now you can see that all the powers are in powers of x power n. Now again, if you want to see the first term of this summation, then you can see that the first term is put n equal to 2. So this will be a 2 into a2 x power 0. That means 2a2. And again, here you consider if you put n equal to 0, then this is your 2a2 x power 0. So the first term is common. So we can replace our n by n plus 2. Now, we will try to make this summation common. So for that, either write all the summation from n equal to 0 to infinity, or write them in terms of n equal to 2 to infinity, or in terms of n equal to 1 to infinity. I am writing all the terms in terms of summation n equal to 2 to infinity. So for that, let us remove n equal to 0 term from here. So your n equal to 0 term means put n equal to 0. So we have 2 into a2. Put n equal to 1, then this will be your 3, this will be your 2, so this will be your 6, a3 into x. Now this summation will move from 2 to infinity. Now this is again from 2 to infinity, put n equal to 1 here, this will be your a1 x. Now this will be from 2 to infinity. Put n equal to 0, 4a0. Put n equal to 1, 4a1 x. Now remaining terms will be from n equal to 2 to infinity. So our summation will move from n equal to 2 to infinity. Then we will have n plus 2, n plus 1, an plus 2. Then the next term is minus n into n minus 1 an. Then the third term is minus n an. Fourth term is 4an. And then we have x power n equal to 0. So we can also write it as 2a2. Then your constant term is 4a0. Then our coefficient of x 6a3 plus 4a1 of x, and this is again a1, so this will be your 3a1. So these are the constant term and coefficient of x. Now the remaining terms, n equal to 2 to infinity, n plus 2, n plus 1, an plus 2. Now let us take these three terms common. So we will have, this is your minus n square plus n. So this plus n and minus n will get cancelled. So we have minus n square plus 4. Minus n square plus 4. So minus n square of the magnitude 4 minus n square an. And then the powers of x power n equal to 0. So this is your equation number 2. Now we will equate the various coefficients of powers of x equal to 0. So your constant term is this one, your coefficient of x is this one, and then the remaining terms will be obtained from this term, which is your coefficient of x power n. So let us equate coefficients of various powers of x equal to 0. Equal to 0. So we have the constant term as 2a2 plus 4a0 equal to 0. So from here our a2 will be minus 2a0. Then we will have 6a3 plus 3a1 equal to 0. So from here our a3 will be minus 1 by 2 a1. So this is our a3. Then the coefficient of x power n will be n plus 2, n plus 1, an plus 2, then 4 minus n square, an equal to 0. So from here our an plus 2 will be n square minus 4, an divided by n plus 2, n plus 1. Now this is your a square minus b square, so we have an plus 2 equal to n minus 2 upon n plus 1, our an. As we do not have any negative coefficients, so our n will move from 0 to infinity. So if you put n equal to 0, then our a2 will be minus 2. Put n equal to 0 here, then your a2 will be minus 2 a0. This is your a2. That means our calculation is matched, so we can say that this is correct. Put n equal to 1, if your n is 1, then this will be your minus 1 divided by 2 a1. See here, your a3 is minus 1 by 2 a1. Now a4, put n equal to 2, this this is 0. If I put n equal to 3, if we put n equal to 3, then this will be 3 minus 2, that means 1. 3 plus 1, 4. A, 3. Put n equal to 3 here, so this will be your A5. Put n equal to 3. So this will be your 1 upon 4, A3. Now your A3 is minus half A1, so this will be your minus 1 by 8, A1. Your A6, put n equal to 4. And this will be your in terms of A4, which is 0, so A6 is 0. And similarly, we can have A7, A9, A11. So our solution is, therefore, our solution is y equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x3 plus a4x power 4 plus a5x power 5 and so on. Please note that our whole solution, our coefficients are in terms of a0 and a1. So we will have to unknowns, one is a0 and another is a1. As the differential equation is of order 2, that is why we are having two unknowns, one is a0 and another is a1. So put the values of a3, a5, a7 in this equation. So the first one will be a0, your a1 is another unknown, a2, our a2 is minus 2 a0, your a3 is minus half a1, your a4 is 0, your a5 and so on. So this is equal to a0 and then 1 minus 2x square, as other terms are 0, so we have only these two terms, and then the coefficient of a1 is x cube minus 2, then x power 5 upon 8 and so on. So this is the series solution of that differential equation. So this is the next question is solve x star plus 1 y double dash plus x y dash minus x y equal to 0 near x equal to 0 using power series solution. Solution. First we will check whether this point is ordinary or singular. So we will write it in a standard form. Now your px is x upon 1 plus x square. Your qx is this one. Here you can see that at x equal to 0, both p and q are finite, and if you want to find their differentiation, then again both p dash and q dash will be finite, so our x equal to 0 is ordinary point because both p and q are analytic at x equal to 0. So let y equal to n equal to 0 to infinity an x minus x naught power n. Your x naught is 0 here, so this will be your n equal to 0 to infinity an x power n, or we can write it as a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube and so on. Let this is the solution of this one, this differential equation. So if it is solution, then it will satisfy this differential equation. So let us find out y dash, y double dash. So your y dash will be from n equal to 1 to infinity n into a x power n minus 1. I have already given explanation for n equal to 1 because for first time differentiation this a0 will be 0. Your y double dash will be n equal to 2 to infinity n into n minus 1 a n x power n minus 2. Put these values in equation number 1, hence by 1. Your first term will be x square into y double dash. This is your y double dash. So if you multiply this term by x square, then you will have a n x power n. Then the second term will be 1 plus y double dash. So this is your n equal to infinity n into n minus 1, a, x power n minus 2. Then your third term, x into y dash. So this is your n equal to 1 to infinity, x power n. Then the fourth term, minus x into y, your x into y. This will be your an x power n plus 1 equal to 0. Again, let us replace, let us make all the powers common. So we will write all the terms in powers of either x power n or x power n minus 2 or x power n plus 1. So these two terms are in powers of x power n. So let us replace our n by n plus 2 here so that we can get the power in terms of x power n. And here we will replace our n by n minus 1. So the first term is n equal to 2 to infinity, n into n minus 1, an x power n. Then this will be your n equal to 0 to infinity, because if you replace your n by n plus 2, then we will have n plus 2 equal to 2. So our n will be from 0 to infinity, n plus 2, n plus 1, an plus 2, x power n. Now this will be your n equal to 1 to infinity, n into an x power n. Then this is your, replace your n by n minus 1. So this will be your, if you replace your n by n minus 1, then we will have n equal to 1 to infinity, a n minus 1, x power n equal to 0. Now again, we have the power as power of x power n. Now let us try to make our summation common. This is from 2, this is from 1, this is from 1, this is from 0. Let us make all the four summation common. And here I am writing all the summation from 2 to infinity. So the first term will be replace. Now the first term is this one, will be from 2 to infinity. Okay. Now let us take n equal to 0 and n equal to 1 term common outside from this summation. If we take n equal to 0 term outside, then we will have this one as minus. Put n equal to 0 here, so this will be your 2 into. Put n equal to 1 here, then this will be 3 to the 6, a 3x. Now this summation will start from n equal to 2. The term of n equal to 1 will be a1x. Now it will start from 2, and this will be your, put n equal to 1 here, so this will be your minus a0. Minus a0x. Now all the summation will move from 2, so we have n equal to 2 to infinity, n into n minus 1, an, minus n plus 2, n plus 1, an plus 2, then we will have n into an, then the fourth term is an minus 1, x power n equal to 0. So equating, so this is equation number 2, equating coefficients of various powers of x equal to 0. Various powers of x equal to 0. We get, now here the constant term will be 2a2. Your constant term is minus 2a2. So minus 2a2 will be 0. So your a2 is 0. So your a2 is 0. The coefficient of x will be 6a3 plus a1 minus a0. So your a3 will be a0 minus a1 divided by 6. Your a3. Then equating the coefficient of x power n, here we will get n into n minus 1 an, n plus 2, n plus 1, an plus 2, plus n an, minus an minus 1 equal to 0. So this will be your an. Now the value of an plus will be n square minus n. So this plus n will get cancelled. So we have n square an minus an minus 1 divided by n plus 1 into n plus 2. So this is the value of an plus 2. And please note that this equation, this is known as initial equation. Sorry, this is known as recurrence relation. Recurrence relation. So this is the recurrence relation between an minus 1 and an plus 2. Now, here again you can see that your n cannot be 0. So our n will move from 1 to infinity. This is your plus. So this has to be plus. So this is your plus. So this term is plus. And if it is plus, so this will be your plus. So now this will be your an minus 1 minus n star an. So this is our an plus 2. Now you can see that if we put n equal to 1 here, then this will be your 1 by 6 a naught minus a1, and this is your a3. Now if this is your a3, find out a4. Therefore our a4 is, put n equal to 2. If you put n equal to 2, then this will be your a1, this will be your a2, a2 is 0, so this term is 0. So on putting n equal to 2, this will be your a1 upon, put n equal to 2. So this will be your 3 into 4, that means 12. So on putting n equal to 2, we have this one as 3, this one is 4, so we have 12. So a4 is a1 by 12. Your a5, put n equal to 3. So on putting n equal to 3, we will have this will be your a2. Again a2 is 0. a2 is 0, so this will be your minus 9 a3 divided by 3 plus 1, 4, 3 plus 2, 5. So this will be your minus 9 upon 20 a3. a3 is a0 minus a1 by 6. So we have minus 3 upon 40 a0 minus a1, and so on. We can have other remaining coefficients. Therefore your y is a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube plus a4x power 4, and so on. So your a0, a1x, a2 is 0, and your a3 is 1 by 6 a0 minus a1x cube. Your a4 is 1 upon 12. Your a5 is minus 9 upon minus 3 upon 50 a0 minus a1x power 5. So therefore our solution is equal to, therefore your, hence our y is equal to a0, then the bracket 1 minus x cube upon 6, then we will have minus 3 upon 40 x power 5, then a1 we will have x minus x cube upon 6 plus x power 4 upon 12, then we will have plus 3 upon 40 x power 5, and so this is your plus x cube.